evening. Welcome to St. Margaret's. It's been a week of the most wonderful music, and we're delighted to have our final recital this evening, a piano recital, and hopefully we'll cap off what has been a marvellous weekend. And I hope you've had plenty of time to enjoy some sunshine, top up those tans. But it's our last recital for this evening, for the season. Would you please welcome Ning Huisi?
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining me here today. That was a serenade and a scherzo by Hensel and Conrad Schumann. A bit of a warm, sunny welcome that matches the mood today. Initially, I was going to play her July for this recital instead of June, right, because of the date. But as I played this twice in June in some other venues, I decided to stick with it. July by Fanny Hensel is a lot more cold. It's in the key of B flat minor, so it doesn't quite match the sun that we have out there. The scherzo by Clara Schumann, which I just finished with, is actually the third movement from her four movement sonata, which was written in 1841 and 42, but didn't get published or premiered until 1989 and 91. I saw somebody raise their eyebrows. That's 150 years. So, now I will be placing the remaining three movements of Clara Schumann's sonata with Dreaming by Amy Beach and Caio Saariaho's Prelude. And I've put all five of these musical movements together because they share a common thread of song, poetry, and romance. In Dreaming by Amy Beach, she quotes a line from Victor Hugo, "You speak to me from the depths of a dream." And in a very similar sort of atmosphere, we have a lullaby theme quoted by Clara Schumann in her second movement. This was actually from Robert Schumann himself upon the birth of their first child, Marie. Caio Saariaho's Prelude is also based on one of her own songs, so many parallels here. And the song's called Longing. So I'll be putting these alongside Clara Schumann's first movement, which quotes her own song, He Came in Storm and Rain, and her fourth movement, which concludes this set of five pieces, which has a very similar melodic outline to her song, They Loved Each Other. So first Amy Beach, then Clara Schumann, then Caio Saariaho, and Clara Schumann again.
Thank you. Thank you.
When I first started learning this sonata in 2018, it's been a journey with this work, I was most attracted to it because the last movement has no performance directions. So Clara Schumann left not much dynamics beyond the first page, which means that it can be anything that I want it to be. And that's really appealing to me as a young performer. So I've stuck with this work, playing it on and off over the last few years. And this very similar sense of returning to a musical home is also present in Emily Koh's Ray Tario. Emily Koh is from Singapore as well, same as me. So I got the chance to speak to her about this piece sometime last year when I was choosing it. And she said that it reminds her of lockdown living, and funny enough, she had finished writing it in 2019, so just the right time. And she said that when she went back to the work and she was talking about it to me, it really brought back some of the memories of her lifestyle that year. And for the final work, I'll be playing Florence Price's Fantasy Negra, which is a genre that she very much invented herself, combining African-American spirituals with European piano fantasy. And that is a very, very proud reflection of her personal identity. So Emily Koh's Ray Tario and Florence Price's Fantasy.
was the most exquisite playing, and really beautiful to watch. And all composers that we should all know a lot better. That was our final recital for the summer. And thank you all for coming. Thank you for the support you've given over the last few months. And we will be back in September. We already have a program fully booked for the autumn leading up to Christmas. So there'll be lots more live music. But thank you once again for a wonderful final performance. Let's give a warm round of applause.